Good morning, Hans. Good to see you again after the German session. Now, the Hannover Messe just started.
Yeah.
So we have 5 days in total now with technology discussions, everything.
Correct.
But it's all about discussion, meeting customers, talk to customers.
Yeah.
And before we talk about technology, I would like to talk with you about sales strategy.
Yeah, okay.
Because we have a specific strategy to make our business globally, because we do direct sales versus indirect sales.
Yeah.
And I noticed that you do this since day one. So why have you decided that our sales force makes a direct sale, us to the customer and back?
Yeah, good question. So you see, 44 years ago when I started the company in the garage, it was really a garage, I started as a system integrator. So I developed solutions for high-end machines already in these days. And this always meant that I had to have a good relationship, and I liked this good relationship with our customers, because I had to understand the application and had to find good solutions for it. And I think this is the way a technology company should work together with the customers. So there has to be a close relationship so that the best concepts can be found, and also problems can be solved from time to time. In a good project, there are always some problems. And then you have to rely on each other. The customer has to rely on the automation supplier, and also the other way around. We have to listen carefully to our customers to get the newest ideas and directions where technology is developing. So this was in the beginning because I was a system integrator, and then we started to become a system and component company. PC control technology as a base, I/O and motion and all the other things as add-ons. Then it was clear to me that we are continuing this way, that we want to have the direct contact to our customers. And this has been true for my German experience, but it also has been true on an international base.
Yeah, but are these same requirements? So is our Chinese, American, Indian, French customer asking the same questions and prefer the direct support?
Yeah, it's a wonderful experience. Automation technology is a worldwide culture.
Yeah.
So if you speak to a Japanese or a Chinese automation engineer, you as a Westphalian or German automation engineer, you very, very fast start to understand each other. So it's really something which is a worldwide culture even. You can see it in this way. So in these days the world is becoming a little bit more unfriendly for the one or other reason, automation technology, I think the automation community is really a worldwide community which talks the same language and can understand quite easily.
Yeah, good point. I mean, you just mentioned your garage, at your house at home. You started the garage, but then you started also to systematically grow our sales. So let's have an insight. I think the first external office was 1993.
Yep, that's true. It was in Balingen.
It
was one in Balingen and one in Hannover, where we are today. And so because I had the luck to meet two gentlemen who were experienced sales engineers and who helped me to build our sales system, and we divided the world in two halves. So one half was starting by the south of Germany to the rest southern world, and the other one was the northern world. And so these two gentlemen were responsible for these halves of the world. And since then, we always organized our sales channel by cell division, to call it in this way. And today, I think we have about 200 offices spread around in the world. And in the developed countries, so that all countries are developed, but the industrial
automation
countries. So we try to let's see Germany as an example. Every 100 or 200 kilometers you will find a Beckhoff office, and in countries which are bigger like the United States or China, maybe it takes 250 to 500 kilometers. But then there will be a Beckhoff engineer available. He will be local, he will talk the local language, he knows the local football club, he knows the local jokes, and he is a high-end technology specialist.
Yeah, and this brought us up today that we have, if I consider this correctly, 1,900 people more or less, which are directly working with and for our customers.
Yeah, you have to see we are about 5,600 employees at all, and 1,900, so more than a third, are working in the one or other way directly with customers. And this is part of our offering to our customers on a worldwide base. So it's not only about hardware and software, it's also about support. And in the end, as we said, it's about trust, because the customer, the machine builder, is laying his future into our hands as a control supplier. So we really have to function, we really have to deliver quality, we really have to deliver innovations, advantages, and therefore there has to be a very close relationship between us and our customers.
I think trust is a good word, because I totally understand that this customer maybe make his own automation, and then he asks us to overtake basically the automation tasks and the hardware. So you need to trust us, but also our local people.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, it's a very important part, because the local engineers, not everything can be done from our headquarters here in Germany. So the local engineers, they have to be together with the customers. They have to develop the architecture of the solution. And they also have to be capable to go deep into the deep technology solution. So this is very important. I think we would not sell anything if not the sales would be there. And by the way, so I always invested in technology development. Yeah. Beckhoff is known for worldwide leading technology. But I always try to invest the same amount of money into developing the sales channel. Yeah. Because for sure, we have to sell our products, but we have to support our customers.
Yeah, that means our toolbox is full of products, is full of salespeople, and both together are a reason for the success. Yeah. But I noticed that besides the sales, then the toolbox is also support, service, and other function features. So I think this is an extra valid point.
For sure, most of our sales engineers are already good automation engineers by their background. So this is the typical Beckhoff sales engineer, so he knows already a lot. But if it's going into details, really how to tweak the bits and bytes and to program in the end, then this is something which cannot be handled by a sales engineer anymore to educate and to help the customer. And therefore we have support and application engineers, or at least for each sales engineer is at least at minimum one application or support engineer which he can use to help our customers. Yeah. And therefore, it means 1, 2, 3 engineers on a local base, maybe in the north of Italy, are responsible for one customer. Yeah.
Now, at this trade show, we put also other things into the toolbox. Mm-hmm. So maybe we'll have a little sneak preview. What are your technology highlights for the next couple of days?
Well, it's you know, we have here these different parts of Beckhoff. So Beckhoff the IPC company, Beckhoff the I.O. company, Beckhoff the motion company, Beckhoff the software automation company, and in each of these business units we have exciting new products. Your product range, so the PC, you have the C6040, which has now up to 28 cores already, which I think is fantastic, and which shows that Beckhoff, we developed the many core control technology already 10 years ago, has foreseen the future, how it will develop, which is not this difficult, but we did it, and other ones did it not in this way. So this is one of the highlights over there. Then in with motion, we have the water-cooled motors, is something new and which enhances our range of performances. We have the new tile in the planar motor technology.
Which can endless rotate.
Which can endless rotate and which is more precise and which has a bigger size. So a lot of advantages with this new tile. We have the MX system where we are standing over here. And which I think has a very big future, because it's really revolutionizing the way cabinets are built and automation is done. I see a lot of parallel developments compared to our introduction of the bus terminal in 1995. This was also a revolution. Nobody had a bus terminal before. Afterwards, it became a standard for almost any control supplier. The same will happen here. So I do not like to invite the other control suppliers, but I'm sure that this is the way to go in future, and the cabinet will be only used for special solutions anymore.
I think a real game changer. Yeah.
And one point which I will not forget is Linux. Beckhoff is now also providing solutions, TwinCAD solutions based on Linux, which is a big step in our philosophy. So we try to open the world for TwinCAD and Linux together.
Yeah, more flexibility on the customer side. Well, perfect, some insights, some sales strategies, many thanks. Good luck with the next days. I'm sure we see us around.
Yeah.